This is the Geophysical Institute on the West Ridge of the University of Alaska campus in Fairbanks. The institute was begun to study the aurora, commonly known as the Northern Lights. Today, the institute's research embraces many fields in the Arctic and subarctic, including seismology.
So the Atomic Energy Commission's nuclear event triggered the interest of geophysicists here, who determined to monitor the explosion. An explosion on remote Amchitka Island, hundreds of miles away from Fairbanks, in the Aleutian chain of islands. This was the scene on the third floor of the institute where scientists double-checked banks of drum recorders prior to the detonation at noon Fairbanks time. Doug Van Warmer of the institute staff explained the devices would measure ground velocity, the seismic wave.
Explain to us how the seismic waves will spread from Amchitka Island.
Okay. At the time of detonation, at what's called ground zero here on Amchitka Island, seismic waves will spread out equally in all directions from the island. 1 minute later, they will have reached this circle in their spreading path. 2 minutes later, they will have reached this circle. 3 minutes later, they will be here onto the peninsula and touching Nunavak Island. 4 minutes later, the waves will arrive at Kodiak and on the Seward Peninsula. Nearly 5 minutes later, the waves will arrive at Fairbanks, which is where we are here. These seismic waves will be recorded on very sensitive instruments from McKinley, Nanana, Tanana, the Gilmore Tracking Station, Eielson Air Force Base, and then down the highway at Black Rapids, Paxson, and Sheep Mountain.
Now, Tanana, Nanana, McKinley, so forth, these are Geophysical Institute measuring field stations?
Yes, these are seismic field stations that we operate routinely, all of these.
And the measurement of the seismic wave will come up then on this brush recorder?
That's correct. This recorder has been arranged so that the arrival of the wave will pass from right to left across you, reaching Tanana first, then Mount McKinley, Park Headquarters, Sheep Mountain, Nenana, Gilmore, and Paxson.
And when the seismic wave runs from the epicenter on Amchitka Island to the village of Tanana, that will be some 1,300 miles, and this will occur 4 to 5 minutes after the actual detonation, any deflection on this needle, and that's what we're looking for.
That's correct. We anticipate that the first deflection on the Tanana station will occur 4 minutes and 37 seconds after the detonation of the device.
A crowd gathered to watch the needles and await their deflection. And the crowd included the Geophysical Institute's director, Keith Mather. Then Van Warmer gave the alert.
In about 7 seconds, we should see a signal arrive at the station here at Tanana, and the signal should move out across the record. In order, from right to left, we should see the seismic waves from the nuclear event Cannikin going across here. There is a considerable difference in amplitude on these traces due to the various beam settings of the stations.
Okay, it just hit Gilmore.
So it just
passed here.
Going wrong somewhere or another here. The waves have now passed through the Fairbanks area. And what we are now seeing is the reflections and reverberations of the primary or the P waves.
It came and it went. No more deflections after that blast, except for one when the shockwave hit the core of the Earth and bounced back.
Right now, the scientists of the Geophysical Institute are measuring the data from that detonation and from the shock waves, a process that could take many days. This is Larry Carpenter on the University of Alaska campus in Fairbanks.